Yes, sir. You already know this. Your boy B Hayes. We back with another one. Let's go ahead and get right into it. You know, we don't have to waste nobody's time. Before we do that, let's give this video a thumbs up so I can reach more people. Today, we'll be touching base on GameStop. That's ticker symbol GME. So, let's go ahead and look at it, y'all. You know, we don't really talk about GameStop much on this channel, and we'll get into details to why we don't. So, we had a request. They want to know, you know, what we thought about GameStop. So, we're going to do a quick update, real quick. So, let's see, let's go ahead and see, y'all. At the time of this recording, we trading at 189. The open was 195. The high was 201. The low was 182. The 52-week high was 483. The 52-week low was 257. Okay. So, as we look on the one-day chart, we got a nice support around 180. 183 to be exact. We got a nice solid support around 183. If we break through that 183, that 180, we in trouble. We could see a nice, huge fall all the way down to around $137. And if $137 support don't hold, we could see another fall all the way down to $101. So now let's go ahead and check out the analysts. Let's see what analysts got a target on GameStop at. The 7 analysts offering 12-month price forecast for GameStop have a median target of $13 with a high estimate of $33 and a low estimate of $350. The median estimate represents a negative 93% decrease from the last price of $194. So they think this thing is way overvalued. They think this thing should be nowhere near the price that it's at. So now, you know what we like to do. You know these companies like to hate on these companies in public, but they be buying the hell out of them in private. So let's see what they got going on. Institutional ownership, 105%. This is what I want to highlight for y'all. 105% of ownership. And you know, the more shares that an institutional own, that's the less shares we able to get as small investors, as retail investors. That's less shares we able to accumulate. So increased positions, 15.9 million shares. Decreased position, 19.5 million. Held positions, 38 million shares. Total institutional shares, 73.5 million. Out of 73.5 million, they decreased their position, 19.5 million. New position, 4 million. Sold out position, 8.1 million. So they holding a big bag of shares in this company for them to be talking about it as they is. You know? And a lot of that could have to do with these shorts got hammered and lost so much money shorting this company. Now they're trying to load up on the long side to recover some of their gains. Because, I mean, my honest opinion, I haven't bought any GameStop. I might have bought one share just to have a part of history, because it's a part of history that's going on. Same thing happened with Volkswagen back in 2008, ran up to $300 per share. So, I mean, I just participated just to, you know, have part of history. But the way I trade, I'm a professional trader. So it's like, I'm not going to just be going off of hype stocks that everybody in, stocks that don't make sense to me. And GameStop didn't make sense at first. It most definitely didn't. Far as like GameStop was like a blockbuster of the gaming, blockbuster movies, but GameStop is games. But GameStop is basically was like a blockbuster for the games. Like people is now, it's 2021. People is graduated from disc, from having to buy disc and put it in the system. Now the only thing you have to do is just go in the store and download a game on your PC, on your console that you want to play. And once it's downloaded, you ain't got to worry about the kids messing it up. You ain't got to worry about nobody stealing the game. The only thing is you can't swap the game out or trade it in because it's downloaded. It's digital. So that's a whole new wave. Just like with Netflix coming, took out Blockbuster. Now you got all the movies screened right there on your TV. And new movies get screened on it every month or every however so often. So it's like it's knocking GameStop out of the park with that. But hold on, let's not go so fast. These institutions could also be loading up because they know that Chewy, the co-founder of Chewy, that Cohen guy, he got 13% stake in GameStop. And with his 13% stake, he's not just in the party, in it for the money, just trying to, you know, get his bread out of it. He trying to actually put his fingers in GameStop and let them know, hey, we can do this. We can turn this company around with all this cash that we raised, with all this. Hey, he coming up with great ideas to help actually turn the company around. So it's like he trying to do the pandemic. And we do know that the pandemic did help boost GameStop e-commerce sales by 257% during the third quarter, but its website could benefit from the kind of digital makeover Cohen can help direct. So Cohen trying to redirect and do GameStop as a digital makeover. So when he already know everything's going digital, so if they going into that type of investment with the company, they most definitely is going to be able to see profits, and big profits at that. So that's something to keep in mind, and that's all I really want to bring to y'all attention, was that institutional ownership, the support, what we got to support at, and resistance. Our resistance is at $190.60, right at 191. If we break 191, GameStop could easily go green, hit $200, and then from there, 208 will be our last resistance. 208-210 will be our last resistance before we can retest that 272, around that 272-280. So in my personal opinion, should you buy GameStop, should you be investing in GameStop? Me, I'm not investing in GameStop. I'm not going to buy any GameStop. The companies that I like that simply plays to GameStop are AMC and Express. I like them. They're very much way cheaper than GameStop, and I feel like they have, you know, I just feel more better about those companies than GameStop, because I don't know, like AMC, when them, once the world reopened, like they already, like they, that's going to be, that stock could shoot up in value, especially if you got in at low prices around $5, $6, $7, $8, where I had recommended that, they would be great prices. And then with Express, I called that out at $2.50. It's trading at almost $5 now, $4 plus. So with those stocks, they're much cheaper. I believe in the company Express. My homeboy worked there in the mall. AMC, I went to their movies, you know, like before the pandemic. And so that's all I got for this video. Just want to give y'all a quick update on GameStop, let y'all know how I feel about that. If you like these type of updates, these type of predictions, consider joining the family. It's your boy B Hayes. We out. Love y'all. God bless.